Alrighty, so we have a pretty exciting construction update today. I was thrilled. In fact, I stood at this field for literally 4 or something hours or something like that, waiting to film this one moment. So hopefully you guys really enjoy this footage, because what I thought was going up, they had this track piece hanging in the air for literally about 4 hours. I guess it was due to the wind or something. But yeah, I waited like 4 hours to get this shot. So hope you guys really enjoy it. I know I'm a little too obsessed. At least I'm aware of it. But anyways, let's get right into it. So the piece they're lifting is about 125,000 pounds. Okay, so picture that. 125,000 pounds floating in the air, waiting to be placed. So it takes quite the team. So it looks like, from what I'm seeing, they have a team of maybe 3 stations. 4 if you count the crane operator, which you should. So you have the crane operator, then you had 1 person in a bucket on the part of the lift hill already installed. You had 1 person on the actual track end. You can't see them in this shot, but there's literally a human being on the end of the lift hill there that's already installed, literally hanging on there, waiting for that track piece to come in. Then you have another party down in another bucket that goes up to the top of that support beam that isn't attached to a track yet piece. So you have 4 people working all together to get this 1 piece of track in. You had the wind working against them. And 125,000 pounds just floating there in the air. So imagine that. So not hating on the fact that it took too long. I totally understand. But what an awesome shot. So obviously, as if you've been watching closely, you can see the teams getting into position. The buckets moving up and down. The team moving. Then you'll start to see in the shots coming, the crane starting to move the track piece closer to installation. Now, to describe how that process goes, it's really slow. It's not as easy as a lot of people think. So getting a 125,000 pound piece of track into its position is really difficult. So what they do is they attach, you know, the actual crane bit. Again, I don't know all the details of construction. I apologize. There's no way I'm going to know all of them. But they attach the crane to the track. Then they attach these chain falls to help angle it. So if you notice, the track stays at I'm guessing 47 degree angle, because it's the angle of the lift hill. The track stays at a 47 degree angle no matter what position the track is being held in the air. And they move the track into position very slowly. I'm talking about a small kind of movement every like minute to 5 minutes here and there. If there's a gust of wind, it'll pause. Or if they need to readjust, it'll pause and be held there. And then they slowly, ever so slightly, move this track piece. Again, I was filming for about 30 minutes of this footage, and it took a long time. So again, they move it ever so slightly and they align it. What you can't see is they also have a cord that goes from the very top part, the highest part of that track angle, that 47 degrees being held by the crane, all the way down, a cord, a steel cord, I'm assuming, all the way down to the ground, that helps them kind of like, I'm guessing it helps them pull it or move it into position, and then they can anchor it as well for safety reasons. I'm not sure, but it looks like they were using it to help move the actual piece of track to the direction they need it to. The support beam, which I thought was going to be an A-frame, and then I literally looked at the blueprints again, it's a V-frame. The only A-frames on this dive coaster is one on the drop. So you have 2 V-frames on the support structure, the lift structure, and then the next column to go up is column 7. So column 7 will be for the top of the lift hill and the turn out of the incline. And then they start again, as I was discussing in a previous video, they start building up that drop. And then they eventually connect the top of the lift hill together as one final piece, not the entire top. Again, whatever doesn't connect to column 7, they'll connect to the drop and the lift, because the lift and the drop act as a support column on B&M coasters. It's actually fascinating. You can see it off in the distance on Leviathan. You'll notice that the top of the lift hill on Leviathan doesn't actually have a support column. It's because it doesn't need one. It actually relies on the lift structure and the drop as a complete support to hold up that little bit on the top. I should say massive bit, because that's a lot of track not being held by support. And don't worry, you're safe. You're more safe than ever on a B&M coaster. They are designed that way to look better. Less supports mean more photogenic coasters. So, yeah. Other than that, I'm not quite sure what was going on. Oh, right here you can see them. So the track piece is in final position. They're bolting it in place. You'll see there's, I'm trying to see if you guys, so if you look closely to the ground, you'll see the truck and then follow that arm up. There's a bucket man, a person in the cherry picker, installing or bolting in that track piece to the support beam. And then you have the person in the orange cherry picker bolting the track piece to the other track piece. And then you have a dude also on the top of the lift hill that was already installed, and helping bolt that track in. It's a very big team effort. And then you obviously have the crane operator holding that 125,000 pound piece of track in place, so nothing happens. Anyways, the rest of the video is some perspective shots. I wanted to show you guys every shot or perspective of the lift hill to give you a better understanding of its sheer size. I will tell you, the drone footage is awesome for showing you what's going on, but it does not put into perspective how massive this thing is. You can now see this lift hill at any angle or corner of this square theme park. So again, you're on the Highway 400, you can see it. You're on Jane Street, you can see it. You're on Major Mackenzie, you can see it. And if you're on Rutherford, you can see it. You can see it from anywhere. So it is definitely at close to, I'm guessing, between 180 to 200 feet tall at the moment. You have, I think, one or two more pieces to go in, but those pieces start to angle out of the lift hill. So it is, those were the final two pieces for the actual just complete incline. So now you have one more piece that's going to go in that starts to angle out of the incline, and you have that final out of the angle incline going on. That's me just showing you guys how far back I am, because again, zoom on the drone gets really up in there. So you're going to see some further perspective shots. I move a little more to the right to show you almost as if you're facing the lift hill. Hope you guys, again, really enjoy this footage. I really wanted to stay and get the track being installed, so I waited the 4 hours to get it on the drone. So as usual, thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate all the views and the likes and the shares that my videos have been getting lately. I seriously did not expect the videos to ever blow up like this, so I'm really thankful. I really appreciate you guys meeting me at the park and complimenting the content that we've been putting out. So thanks so much for doing that. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't as usual, and share this video for others to watch. And thanks so much. Hopefully you enjoy the rest of the video. Have a good one, guys. Bye.